From Nashville, Tennessee, it's Country Music Time, brought to you by your local Air Force recruiter and this radio station. Now here's the star of this week's show, Karen Taylor.
Well, he don't dress like a downtown city dandy. He don't talk like a lawyer on a case. He can't sing a song like Kenny Rogers. Hollywood's not looking for his face, but I don't care what he's not, 'cause he's solid like a rock, and he works hard like a man, that's enough. Well, he's not sparkling or witty, and he sure isn't pretty, but then neither is a diamond in the rough, and my man is a diamond. The way he is, well, I guess he never will. But I don't care what he ain't got, 'cause he's solid like a rock, and he works hard like a man, that's enough. Well, he's not sparkling or witty, and he sure isn't pretty, but then neither is a diamond in the rough. Yeah, I don't care what he's not, 'cause he's solid like a rock, and he works hard like a man, that's enough. Well, he's not sparkling or witty, and he sure isn't pretty, but then neither is a diamond in the rough, and you know my man is a diamond.
Karen Taylor, welcome to Country Music Time.
Thanks. It's good to be here, Pete.
It's a pleasure to look at your pretty face and talk to a lady whose voice I've heard so many times and didn't even realize it.
Ain't that something?
Yeah. I mean, watching television and seeing Kellogg's and McDonald's commercials, Eastern Airlines and Schlitz, just to name a few. You poor thing.
Now, I will admit that most of those, I am buried amongst about 8 singers.
Oh.
But well, there's some good things in the works that I'll be shining on.
It has definitely helped your career to the point where you are now, though.
Yes, it has.
To where you have, Diamond in the Rough was a top 40 single for you.
Sure was.
But what we're about to hear here shortly is a song that, as we're taping right now, is on the country charts at number 74 with a bullet, which I'm sure you're very proud of.
I'm real excited.
How did the transition from singing jingles and commercials to what you're doing now take place?
Let's see. I've been writing for a long time, my songwriting partner and I. And I used to live in Memphis. I lived there for about 7 years and sang at a jingle mill.
Mm-hmm.
Where we came in and sang for 6 hours a day straight and sang jingles. And there was really no place in Memphis for our kind of music, and we just sort of ended up drifting over to Nashville. And I started doing studio work here, and I think singing background on a lot of the country artists' albums really helped me get my direction in mind. And I knew I had to do it, too.
Including a very exciting album that a lot of people are waiting for, the George Jones-Merle Haggard collaboration.
That was a wonderful project.
I can imagine.
It was so much fun. I got to tell you about a song on there. Can
do
I
it.
Tell you about
yeah.
a song on there? It's called No Show Jones.
Better you say that than me.
Oh, well, George and Merle are singing it together, and they're singing a duet, and then at the end, all of a sudden, it's just Merle by himself, and he goes, wait a minute.
Lock the doors.
It's really funny.
That's a terrific idea. But it had to happen, right?
Uh-huh.
With all the publicity that George gets on these little stunts. But let's talk about Karen Taylor. You got some ideas for an album that you're working on.
Yes, we're working on an album. What else can I say? That's real exciting.
Is it hard work?
Yeah, but it's a lot of fun. It's a lot of fun. There's a lot of good writers in town in addition to the stuff that we have written. So it's real exciting.
It's neat that you can walk into a studio like this and, our engineer, Jack Logan, knew you right away. And there's a gentleman in the studio, too, who knew you.
Sure, I work with him.
Because you've worked with him. You've worked with just about everybody in town, haven't you?
Yeah.
Well, Janie Fricke got started that way, too, didn't she?
Yes, indeed. Janie and I, I've been sort of 3 years behind her all the way. It's real crazy. We sang in Memphis together.
Boy, have you got some exciting years ahead of you then.
Well, I sure am hoping so. It's crazy how it's paralleled. I just went to Chicago last week and sang, 2 days ago, and sang some United Airlines stuff, which is what she did. It's crazy. Mm. But I love her. I'm proud to be following in her footsteps.
You were talking about Memphis. There definitely is a Memphis sound that's much different than the Nashville sound, isn't there?
I think you're right. Maybe it's got some more soul-flavored stuff in it.
I know the last time we had the Kendalls on the show, they said that they recorded their last album in Memphis.
Ah.
And they were really happy with the new sound. They were looking for a new sound to go along with those harmonies that they do. And I noticed a difference in the music in, from their earlier releases. I guess that's if you're looking for a different sound and you're tired of the Nashville sound for a while, that's the place
to go. A lot of people go to Muscle Shoals for the same reason,
to
get a different... Yeah. Of course, fortunately, we have lots of people from Memphis and Muscle Shoals coming to Nashville for the Nashville sound, which keeps me in business, too.
the grass is always greener.
Uh-huh.
Well, let's listen to your latest release, which is on the charts as we're recording the show right now. It's called Country Boy's Song. Can you tell us a little bit about it before we play it?
I adore this song. Unfortunately, I did not write it. I wrote the B-side, though, which we're going to hear in a minute. It was written by my songwriting partner, Taylor Sparks, and another fellow named John Dockery. And I love the story. That's all I can say. Just listen to it.
Here's Karen Taylor.
Well, his mama said his first guitar was twice as big as he was. Gave his first performance when he was only three. Accompanied by a whippoorwill, no one believed their ears. It was the sweetest song that had come along in at least 200 years. And that night those hills just came alive with that country boy song. And you know the lightning bugs came out just to help us sing along. With grandma's rocker squeaking on the front porch keeping time. All the worldly cares that were gathered there disappeared in a rhythm and rhyme. Now country life ain't right. 'Cause one thing kept us going and made it all worthwhile. When that sun went down, we'd all gather round and help him sing our country style. And at night, those hills just came alive with that country boy song. And you know the lightning bugs came out just to help us sing along. With grandma's rocker squeaking on the front porch keeping time. All the worldly cares that were gathered to Nashville town, and it seemed the whole world passed away when that evening sun went down. Our days grew long and harder back in 1953, till one Saturday night by the kerosene light we heard the Grand Ole Opry.
And now here's Air Force Sergeant Pete Franquet with a few words about the United States Air Force.
Thank you, Karen. Today's Air Force is one of the best opportunities for a young man or woman. For starters, we have good pay with regular salary increases. There's also housing and meals or allowances if you live off base. How many other organizations offer complete medical and dental care, plus 30 days of vacation with pay each year? Don't forget about technical training. The Air Force provides training in more than 130 skills. It's valuable training that can give you a head start toward a promising career. We can also help you earn a college degree. When Air Force members take civilian college courses, the Air Force can pay up to 75% of tuition. Add it all up, and you get more than a paycheck. You get a great way of life and a great place to start. Your Air Force representative has all the details. Give us a call today.
believe and won't. I feel as nervous and as foolish as a high school girl on her first night out in this big old world. If my mama saw me now, she would call it a sin, but she never had to start her life all over again. Everything has changed and this is all so new. I don't know where to go and I don't know what to do. It's not easy for a one-man woman without her man. He was the only man that I had ever known, from 10 years old till I was fully grown. While other girls were dating, I always had my own, and I never learned to cope with being all alone. It's not easy for a one-man woman without her man. Oh, mama, if you tried, I think you'd understand this emptiness inside me and how lonely I am. I came into this place 'cause I'm so all alone. I'm afraid someone will want me, but more afraid they won't. It's not easy for a one-man woman without her man. No, it's not easy for a one-man woman without her man.
Mellow tones of Karen Taylor and One Man Woman. Now, you wrote that one.
Yes, I wrote it with my partner, Taylor Sparks.
And that's the B-side of your current hit Country Boy song, which I like very much.
Oh, boy.
Apparently, a lot of people do because it's getting a lot of airplay all over the country.
Yay!
Karen, it's been real nice meeting you, and I hope we'll see you, a lot more of you, both on the charts and in person.
Thank you. I hope so, too. I had a good time, Pete.
Country Music Time was recorded live in Nashville, Tennessee, and brought to you by your local Air Force recruiter and this radio station. Technical direction by Chuck Hausey. Engineering by Jack Logan. This is Air Force Sergeant Pete Franquet saying thanks again to Karen Taylor and reminding you to contact your local Air Force recruiter to get details about Air Force experience. It could be your ticket to a great way of life.